Of the many classic Sega arcade racing games, there are a few that seem to have fallen into obscurity. Here's one that you've probably seen before. Manx TT Superbike, a motorcycle racing game created by Sega in 1995 for the arcades, then ported to the Sega Saturn and PC 2 years later in 1997. The game had you racing on two tracks that took you through the Isle of Man TT, a world-famous motorcycle racing event that takes place on the Isle of Man. Growing up, it was always my favorite game to watch in the arcades. I was still very little at the time when I first saw it, and I wasn't really able to control the bike or keep my balance on it. I remember always watching my brothers play it and having a blast, and as I got older, the better I got at it and the more fun it became to play as I learned the weird power slide-like turning that the game uses. Unfortunately though, the machine in my local arcade has fallen on hard times and seems to be in disrepair according to the staff that works there. On the bright side though, when traveling 60 miles south across state lines to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, BOOM! Found one in perfect working condition. Even the fake exhaust pipe is still intact. After the long lull since the last time I played the arcade version, I still find the game incredibly fun and challenging to play. There's a lot of skill involved to fight your way to first place. Or that could just be the rubber band AI. Regardless, I still recommend you play it if you happen to come across it. What we're here to talk about today, though, is the Sega Saturn port, which actually has a little bit of history with me attached to it. Like I said earlier, Manx TT Superbike was released on the Sega Saturn in 1997, and to the PC the same year. This game was actually the very first Sega Saturn game I ever played, and I put played in quotes by the way. Walking into Toys R Us with my mom and my two older brothers, we came across the Sega Saturn kiosk where the video games were, and I remember Manx TT Superbike being the playable game, because I recognized it from the arcade. I think we were playing it on the 3D controller, because we weren't used to having the triggers be the accelerator and brake. That being said, we couldn't figure out how to get the bike to move. We pressed all the buttons and everything, but nothing. Anyways, Manx, Sega Saturn port. Damn, does it look good for a Saturn game. Sega did an incredible job with getting the game to look almost exactly like it did in the arcades, and that was quite a feat for back in the day. While the graphics do impress, the game feels a bit light in a few spots. For one, the controls aren't quite up to snuff for the game. If your primary input for a Sega Saturn is one of the many digital controllers, you are probably going to hate this game. For me, the game's primary viewpoint is the first-person view, and when using a digital controller, the game becomes almost impossible to play, with a camera constantly jerking left and right. While you can certainly play the game in the third-person view, controlling the bike with a digital controller still feels odd, and you can oversteer pretty easily. It's nowhere near the precision you get from playing Sega Rally or Daytona USA. In order to properly play Manx, you'll need the 3D controller, and it does a fairly good job, but can be very touchy and sensitive, but that was the case with most racing games that used it. One thing that really holds this game back though is the lack of features. You only get two tracks to race on. Only two. The extra tracks are just reverse mirrored versions of these courses, and they can get old very quickly. The extra bikes also don't really add much, besides their pretty colors. The game also features a two-player mode, which plays totally fine. In the end, Manx TT Superbike is a fun racing game with a few shortcomings. While it does lack a few features, like tracks, and the controls can be a nuisance at times, the game is still fun to play in short bursts. While it doesn't have the staying power of other Sega Saturn racers, like Sega Rally, it can still be enjoyable to go back to from time to time. You can find Manx online pretty easily, starting at about $3, with complete copies going up to about $10. I personally wouldn't pay too much for this game, but I'd still recommend you give it a shot.